Hey everybody, it's Mr. 95 Cents. We're here for Mr. 95 Cents Sport Card Adventures. What's going on? Oh, we're going to open some more Topps Chrome Platinum. This is one of my favorite products of the year, so I'm going to open one of them again because I got an excuse to do it because I'm doing a video. All right, we're going to do a big shout out to all our featured channels down below. Check them out. Hours and hours of entertainment down there. If you want to be a featured channel, let me know. As long as you're family friendly, I can do it. All right. We can always add people. Yep, we have a lot of fun watching those videos. Before I go on to the prizes, though, I got a package. I got a package from Dr. Mantis Teeboggin. Ooh, watch out. So, well, a nice envelope. Let's see what's in here. Thank you very much. Let's see. It's a mystery envelope. Oh, look at this here. Oh, wow. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I got to unwrap it. Hold on. Oh, you're maybe not supposed to open it. I don't know. Okay. I'm looking. Oh, no, here it is. Here it is. I'm getting seen now. I found out how to open it. So I see some Yogi stamps. Here we go. Oh, we got a little note in there. Hello, Daryl. Hope you are having fun. Happy holidays. Your buddy, Sean, a.k.a. Dr. Mantis Teeboggin. Use these however you want. Oh, this is nice. Look at that. Oh, geez. Thanks very much, Yogi. I'll keep these. Thanks. I don't think I have these. I have older stamps. I haven't really collected stamps in a while. But anytime that because I used to go to the post office all the time. And then when the pandemic hit, I started pickups at the house. And it's so easy, so I never went back to the post office. I haven't probably walked in a post office in, 3-4 years? But I used to always get the sports ones. But thank you very much. I don't have those. Those are nice. That over there? What's in this one? Let's see. Oh, okay. I see that. Oh, that's nice. All right. Oh, so he sent me a nice... Oh, this is funny. So it's a Mark Giordano card, but he put my other brother Daryl on it. Giordano. And on the back, look at that. The funny thing is, my brother's name is Mark, and he was a hockey player. So anytime I get Mark Giordano, I'm going to keep this one because this is mine. But when I find Mark Giordano cards, I give them to him. Oh, thank you. And let's see. Oh, we got a nice DJ LeMahieu. Oh, that's nice. From the Yankees. Nice. Well, geez, thanks very much, Sean. Appreciate it. Now, that's nice. Those Yogi stamps, I'm going to save them, put them with... I do have other stamps, and I think they made Yogi back, you know. So those are nice, though. Thank you very much. All right, we're going to go to prizes. All right, so if you are commenting on the video, last video, and you're a subscriber, you have a chance for one of these prizes. We have... which one's this one? Hold on. 2022 Chronicle Football Pack for first out of the box. Second out of the box, we got a Tom Brady stargazing card. That's from Absolute. Third out of the box, we got a numbered out of 499 certified Immortals Dan Marino card. And fourth out of the box, we got a Rookies and Stars Touchdown Club Patrick Mahomes. There you go. All right, we got a lot of names in the box. Let me move these prizes now so I got room for the box. A lot of tickets in here. We're gonna mix it. Hand mix them first. Here we go. All right, we got them hand mixed. Now we're gonna shake them up. All right. Good luck, everybody. We're going for the pack first. I'm going in. Make sure we got one. Here it is. Oh, Freedom Sufferer. Freedom Sufferer. He won not too long ago. Freedom Suffer, he gets the pack. Here we go. All right, we're going for the Stargazing Tom Brady. Here it comes. Oh, look at this. Kevin O'Keefe. He's just been complaining on the messages that he hasn't won lately, which I think he won a couple months ago. That's not too bad. But his wife is always expecting packages from me. So now she's going to be happy. All right, there you go. We got the Immortals, Dan Marino. Okay, only one. Oh, Pastor Ken G. Hey, Pastor Ken G. I'll see him and Beth at the kitchen table box break. Next, this Monday coming up. All right. And we got the Touchdown Club, Patrick Mahomes. All right. There it comes. Oh, it's my buddy, the Buck Stops here. There he is. The Buck Stops here. There we go. All right. So that's our four winners for this video. We're going to show you some prizes at the end. For if you comment on this video, you got a chance the next video on those prizes. All right. We're going to go right to Warehouse Finds. Got a lot of Warehouse Finds. A lot. Okay. So let's see what we got first. First, we got some Topps Premier. These are from 93, 94, I believe. USA cards, Jim Campbell. They're nice. They got the USA logo on the front and the back. There it is. That's the USA. And we got a John Hildebrandt. There's 23 different ones. I got to find the rest. We got an old score Owen Nolan rookie. And we found another one of those steel cards. Oh, there we go. We got a steel Corey Hirsch from the Leaf. Leaf Preferred Steel. With the coating on it and everything. Got a Marquee Attraction. This is a dark card. Alexei Yashin. Marquee Attraction from Upper Deck. We got an Opeachy Chrome Joseph Stumpel, and it's a, what are they calling this? Season's Best. Very shiny card. Excuse me. This is a newer card. We got a Upper Deck Ice Battle from MVP, Alexis Lafreniere. I found one of these guys. I got to give it to Julie. This is a NHL prospect from 1990. Link Gates, who I remember there was a guy who used to come in the store and used to try to get all the Link Gates cards. I don't know. Is he some kind of, I don't want to say legend, but I don't know. He used to talk to me about Link Gates. Oh, yeah, he was this, he was that. Okay. We got an Upper Deck Checklist. Charlie McAvoy and Moritz Seider. It's a checklist. Oh, this is an older one. This is from 1998. We got a... Who made this one? Let me see. Oh, it's a Skybox Impact card. Remember when they made hockey? The NHL on Fox, it's a beautiful thing. Roman Ascuta, I guess it is. And on the back, it's got... Cold Hard Facts. The puck must completely clear the goal line and enter the net to be counted as a score. No kidding. I tell you what, my hairdo is going crazy. I tried to go to I'm going tippy now. I tried to go to the barbershop Friday. I didn't get there that early. 9:30 in the morning, it was closed. Usually open 8 o'clock. It was locked up and dark. So I'm just worried about my barber. He's 84, 85 years old. I just hope he's okay. I'm going to try again this week. If not, I got to see if I can find out what's going on. Because I'm going too hippie. We got a first 91 score, first round draft choice, Eric Lindros. All We got another MVP ice battle, Jacob Trouba. Oh, we got some Brooklyn Dodgers coming, baseball. So we got a bunch of Brooklyn Dodgers. We got a Diamond King Pee Wee Reese. They still have fans out there, the Brooklyn Dodgers. This is nice. It's a Topps insert. Dukes of Flatbush. Duke Snyder. Got another Diamond King. Leo DeRocha. This is a nice one. Stadium Club has the best photos. We got a Stadium Club Duke Snyder. He used to do all the local shows. We used to have this company Pastime. He used to do a lot of shows up near the Meadowlands, and he did almost every baseball show they had, so I met him quite a bit. We got a 2008 Threads Carl Erskine. These are the greats of the game. Johnny Padres. Oh, this is the Topps 60s. All right. So, MLB RBI in the 50s, it says on the top. So, I guess it looks like he had the most RBIs of anybody in the 50s. Yeah, he did. He was number one with RBIs in the 50s with 1,031 RBIs. Even like Mickey Mantle has 841. So that's pretty good. He was a great player. Oh, this is a funny card. Another great Stadium Club shot. Pee Wee Reese. We got a Diamond King Carl Furillo. There he is. Gil Hodges. Diamond King. I thought this was a funny card. It's a Topps card. And it has Dodgers 1952 National League Champions written on the bat that they're holding. And Jackie Robinson's right in the middle. Look at that bat. Well, we got some Shohei Ohtani cards. Oh, this is nice. We got a rainbow foil Shohei Ohtani from 2020. Oh, we got a nice chrome refractor of Ohtani from 2019 with the rookie cup. So Mike Trout. This is a nice card. I like this card. And it's a holiday card. Topps Holiday with Trout going over the wall and stealing one. Got a roll call from Big League Mike Trout. This is another good one. It's a wall climber from Big League, Mike Trout, going over the wall. We got from Topps a significant statistics card of Mike Trout. Yeah, these are one of my favorites. The then and nows from Topps Heritage. We got a Louis Aparicio and Mike Trout. Oh, these were nice too. The Bowman Best Mirror Images. You got Trout and then Benintendi. Oh, this is one of the, I think it's the Big League, right? Yeah. Does it say? Doesn't say. I believe it's one of the Big League 88 retro things. Foil Mike Trout. Those are nice, the foil cards. Got a lot of Mike Trout here. And one more. We got a Bowman Chrome Series Next die cut of Mike Trout. Oh, Aaron Judge next. Got all the good guys. 2021. It's a Stadium Club refractor. Here we go. Of Aaron Judge. Got that a Topps Chrome Pink refractor from 2018 of Aaron Judge. Well, we got a rookie. We got a 2017 Topps rookie from Aaron Judge. Yeah. Starting to pile up. I gotta put some over here. Oh, this is nice. Last but not least, we got a nice prism stained glass Aaron Judge. We got some basketball. What do we got in basketball here? We've got a Generations from Upper Deck Latrell Sprewell. Got a Ionics. What are they calling this here? Does it say basketball basket 84? Some kind of insert, looks like Scottie Pippen. That's when he was on the Blazers. We got a Biographics from Upper Deck John Stockton. And we got a regular Topps rookie of Allen Houston. Pretty popular when he was on the Knicks. This is just a regular card, but they're nice. Luxury box. And that was from Topps, I believe, right? Yeah. And it's Oscar Robertson, the big O. And he's got like a holographic thing in there going on. The big O. And we got a Jerry West. We got a Fleer Greats of the Game Jerry West card. Let's see, played for West Virginia. Oh, we got some Kobe Bryants. We got a nice, from 1415, we got a nice prism Kobe Bryant. It's a nice shot. We got the 96-97 scoreboard, one of the rookies, Kobe Bryant. Collegiate rookie, we'll call it. We got a second year. These were fun. The Z-Force cards from Skybox. We got a 97-98 Kobe Bryant. We got a nice hard court Kobe Bryant from 2000. Got a, from Hoops, a High Honors 2007-2008 NBA MVP Kobe Bryant. Got his MVP trophy. A Prism Dominance Kobe Bryant. And we got a bunch of these Hoops inserts. Yep, here they are. So Kobe, almost every basketball product after he passed away had a tribute insert set. This was a nice one, though. The NBA Hoops. That's from 2017-18. We got, I'll show you a bunch of them. There's no real title on them. Just different shots of Kobe and how many cards were in the set. It doesn't even say how many cards there. In fact, they're regular numbered regular cards in the set, except one has a red back. Okay, so maybe there was red backs and black bats, but here we go. I'll just show you a bunch of them. All great shots of Kobe. That's a good one. Look at that. That's fun. There's the red back one. I remember where I was when he passed away. I was actually running a Magic tournament in the store, and I had the computer on doing the scores for the Magic, and all of a sudden pop-ups were coming on my laptop, showing that we sold this Kobe Bryant, that Kobe Bryant on eBay, and I says, "Oh, something happened," and I turned on the news, and it was bad news. All right, what do we got here? We got some football coming up, some old stuff first. This is from 1975. We got some 1975 football cards, just mixed. We got a Joe Owens from the Saints, from 1975. A Nate Wright from the Vikings. Jerry Levius from the Chargers. Got a Bill Van Usen from the Broncos. Got a Herb Orvis from the Lions. Morris Stroud from the Oilers. Got a Larry Stallings from the Cardinals. Bob Lee from the Falcons. And Mel Blunt from the Steelers. Bunch of old guys from 1975. Oh, we got a lot of new guys. First, we got some Dan Marinos coming. All right. So what do we got here? We got Dan Marinos. Jeez, we got a bunch of Dan Marinos. Quite a few. All right, looks like Dan Marinos, Tom Brady's. And let's break them up a little bit. All right, so let's see what we got. Dan Marino, we got a Absolute Revolutionaries Dan Marino. Very shiny card. These are always nice. The Prism Draft Picks. They were nice cards. We got a Retro Series Marino. Got a Gridiron Legacies Dan Marino. A Super Bowl Dreams Dan Marino. Is a Super Bowl Moment Dan Marino. So, if I remember right, Dan Marino was in the Super Bowl his rookie year. They did not win, and he was never in the Super Bowl again. Is that crazy? Great quarterback like that. All right, what else we got here? We got a 93 Pro Bowl Dan Marino. A Contenders Legacy from 2019. Tony Dorsett and Dan Marino. We got a Legendary Contenders Dan Marino. A Playoff Heroes Dan Marino. A Legacy Legends Dan Marino. We got an old Upper Deck Crash the Game Silver Dan Marino. All right. Put these over here. And we got Tom Brady. All right. What do we got in Tom Brady? We got a Touchdown Masters Tom Brady from Mosaic. We got a Rookies and Stars. These were nice. The Airborne cards. They were nice cards, Tom Brady. It's a Prism version also. We got a Red, White, and Blue Prism Tom Brady. Got an Elite Game Face Tom Brady. Got a Donruss Dominator. That's a nice card, Tom Brady. Got a Prism Draft Pick Crusade, Tom Brady. This is a Gridiron King, Tom Brady. A Donruss Super Bowl Champions, Tom Brady. An Absolute Kickoff Week 1, 2011, Tom Brady. Those over here. Now we got some soccer cards. All right, and I don't know most of these guys, but they're older. They're from 94, 93 and 94 Upper Deck. So let's see. Who we got first? Athens Asios Koladesikakis. I don't know. He's got a wild hairdo. That's all I can tell you. The name is not easy to pronounce. He's from Greece. From Ireland, we got David Kelly. That's an easy one. From Belgium, who we got from Belgium? Luis Oliveira Barroso. From Greece again, we got Nikolas Tsitsikas. I don't know. Something like that. From Ireland again, we got a Ray Houghton. From Holland, we've got Rob Wistage or something like that. And this is funny. I thought the guy's name was Boer. This is from the Netherlands. And it's a Boer insert card. And there's a player on the front. I'm not sure who he is. But it's not about the player on the front, I don't believe. On the back, it tells you all about Bora Milutinovic, who was the U.S. coach, is the only man to have three different teams to the World Cup finals in addition to the 94 host. He coached Mexico in 86 and Costa Rica in 90. All right, then it goes into Spanish. It's a unique card. All right, so that's that. On our warehouse finds, that's our warehouse finds. There's always a lot of stuff. I'm looking at like three row shoe boxes, and that's all I took out of it. So I don't want to be here forever showing you warehouse finds. That's a little sampling. Where do our warehouse finds go? Some of them go to our show stuff, their live shows. Some go for prizes. Some goes on eBay. Some goes on COMC. So check them out if you're interested in any of that stuff there. And some just go back into my private collection because I like them. All right. So card shop stories. Get ready. Let me have a little coffee first. I got my coffee here. All right. So on card shop stories, this got reminded in my brain. One of my longtime customers who really lives out of state most of the time now, between Washington, D.C. and California. I believe that's where her kids live now. So she goes around. She still has a residence here, though, I believe. So, and she was a longtime customer. Her kids grew up in the store. I think her one son worked in the store for a little bit. So I know them pretty well. So she got divorced early on. And, I remember, and she's collected with the kids all the time. They loved their cards. They still love their cards. And she came by. She was in town, not for long, maybe a week or so. Just, she came to visit and get cards for her son and grandson. So her son still likes, sports cards. So we got him a nice box of basketball because he likes basketball. And her grandson likes Pokemon. So I got him a very sought-after Japanese pack. It was all sealed. And some Japanese holos, because that's what he wanted, was some Japanese cards. He also wants a Charizard. I got to find it. I got a Charizards around here somewhere, but I got to find them. So, I told her, I said, I'll try. But there's like 40 equivalent to probably 43-row shoe boxes in this office here, and they're in there somewhere. I don't know where. But anyway, I'm going to tell you a story. And this is a little, message to everybody to be careful with your collections. And I do use different examples. We had a lot of people coming into the store. I think at the end, we had 500-600 customers that would come on a monthly basis, at least. Some like every other day. But anyway, so I heard a lot of these stories. And unfortunately, too often, and I want to say every few months I'd hear one of these stories. So what happened with this one customer, she befriended a younger man, let's put it that way, and they were going out, and then he ended up moving in with her. And it was a weird thing because at one point, I think after a while, it was a while, probably a good 6 months or 8 months, I believe. He had like a girl move in with them or something. It was a weird thing, Turns out I think that girl was really his girlfriend. And I think they were just looking to rip this poor lady off, because that's what happened. And she had a really good collection. And I remember when it happened because it was bad. One day she comes home, because I don't believe he was working either. She was working, but he wasn't. And a lot of the valuable stuff was gone, including cards. You know, just out of the blue. You know, and I saw the guy. He seemed like a decent guy, you know, but I said, you know, I was a little bit wary. Out of the blue, this guy showed up, you know. And he'd come to the store, you know, with her. And he seemed very friendly, but you got to watch. I know this is a bunch. I've told a bunch of stories about people. Somehow a stranger befriends somebody or you in the family and gets in. And it comes around the whole time. They're just looking to rip you off. It's disgusting. But this is what happens sometimes, you know. There are a lot of flim-flam people out there, a lot of thieves, and they have no problem, you know, befriending you. Some of them seem like the best people in the world, but they're looking to steal. So be very careful. I think if you brought somebody in the house you really didn't know that well, lock your stuff up, and you have the only key for at least a couple years until you get to know them. You know, I mean, all right, they can break the door down, but that's beside the point. At least make it a little tougher. It's terrible. I know, you know, I had a lot of good people working for me, but I've had people steal from me working. You know, I mean, most didn't, because I knew them. Most of the employees in the store were kids that came up through the store, and I'd hire them, you know. So they were all really good, but, you know, a couple people got tempted, and that was it, you know. So just be very careful. It's a little warning, little card shop story warning to be careful with your collection. Let's put it that way. Especially times are rough a little bit now. I don't care what the president says about the economy. It's not that great, and people are looking for money. What are you going to do? And they get tempted. And they have no conscience, some of them. So, but most of the people out there are right, but you never know. And that's my little card shop story warning thing. All right. So we're going to rate the box break. Let's see here. So I've opened a couple of these before. I like them. I like them. And there was nothing really great to open. Nothing like brand new. And I wanted to do a baseball. So I said, get something you like. This way, if it goes up or down, you still like it. And I like this stuff. So they give you, this is 2022, came out late, you know. 32 total cards they give you. Let's see, 7 packs plus 1 extra pack, 4 cards per pack. And you get 3 exclusive Prism Refractor cards per box. So let's see what we get. Let's see here. And there's a chance for autographs. I've seen guys pull autographs out of this, the blasters. And these boxes, I think, are going for about $30 now. So they're still pretty affordable. And they're nice. They're nice. All right, let's see what we got. Oh, we got a Joe Ryan rookie. Aaron Ashby rookie. And right away, we got an upside down card. Let's see. Oh, wow, this is nice. Numbered to 199, we got a nice Orlando Cepeda refractor. That's nice. They give you some nice color in these. We got a Kirby Puckett. And we got a Blue Wave refractor rookie card of Ellis Montero. So, geez, in the first pack, we got two color. I think I did do one hobby. When the hobby boxes came out, I think they were, at first, I picked one up for $100. And then they went up. And I used that box for kitchen table. And we did all right with it. I think that we got an Andre Dawson autograph. You get one autograph for a hobby box. But now those boxes are like $150. So I'd rather open 5 of these, you know. So let's see here. Because, you know, $120 is my limit. We got a Robbie Grossman, Trey Mancini, got a refractor of Colton Wong, and an Adrian Beltre. Oops. Well, so far I've gotten something, at least a refractor in every pack. All right, this pack's going to be plain, it looks like, but that's all right. We got a Liam Hendricks, Jack Flaherty, got Luke Voit, and a rookie card of Cooper Hummel. Let's see what we got. We still got a bunch of packs. So they actually give you five. Yeah. I guess they give you an extra pack. That's what it said. All right. Ooh, right away on the top. Nice. Got a nice Hank Aaron. I like the mix of the old and the new players they do here. Keith Hernandez. Got a Ricky Henderson. A Jaron Duran rookie. Oh, this is nice. We got a nice wave refractor of Carl Yastrzemski. So far, we got two refractors out of the first pack. We've averaged a refractor every pack, which is not bad. Hopefully, we can keep that up. All right, we got a Bryce Elder rookie. Gio Urshela. We should have never got rid of him, the Yankees. We got an Alfonso Rivas rookie. And a Jorge Soler. All right, we still got three packs to go. Oh, Lou Brock right on the top. We got a Dennis Eckersley. We got a rookie refractor card of Angel Zerpa. Right there, and a Julio Arias. Two more packs to go. Oh, Luke's pulling in. Watch out. All right, let's see. Clear this chair just in case he wants to sit down. All right, we got two packs left. We got a Packy Naughton rookie, Kervin Castro rookie, a Jackson Kowar rookie. A lot of rookies in this one, and a George Springer. All right, the last pack. Maybe we get some last pack magic. You never know. We got a Jazz Chisholm. Ozzie Albies. We got a Jared Walsh. We got a Yankee coming up. We got a Gerrit Cole. And we got a Ryan Howard wave refractor. Hey, Luke, what's going on? Luke made it. Yep. I'm just getting to the end of the video, Luke. Right before I ready to do the video, Jim Carter called me. Had me on the phone for half an hour. All right, but that's all right. So we did all right. We got, let's see. So one, count the refractors. Got a lot of rookies. I didn't get no Julio. Julio's in this. Two, let's see. We got three. Four, five. Looks like we got six refractors, including the one numbered out of 199. Not bad. Out of a blaster box, I can't complain. Nope. Put that over there. And throw these over there. All right. And that's our box break. All right, so we gotta get ready to close here because Luke needs a computer to start doing some work. So we gotta have, prizes. Let's see here. So if you comment on this video and you're a subscriber, next video you got a chance for these prizes. First out of the box, we got a 2021 Gypsy Queen pack. Second out of the box, I know we got a lot of Canadian fans out there. We got a older pristine. What year is this from? Does it say? Looks like it might be 2003. 20 years old. Josh Phelps autograph when he was on the Blue Jays right there. Third out of the box, we're talking about the Brooklyn Dodgers earlier. We got a nice Hall of Fame plaque, a Duke Snider, numbered in 1980. And then fourth out of the box, we got a Studio Gold, the credit cards. This is the parallel of the regular. Andres Galarraga. I thought those were always cool cards that look like a credit card. Yeah. And that's our prizes. All you got to do is subscribe, be a subscriber, and make a comment on this video, and you got a chance on the next video for those. All right, we're getting ready to get out of here, do some work, put a lot of stuff on eBay. Look at all the stuff. We got big stacks. Wow. So don't forget, check out our eBay. It's SportsPG on eBay. And on COMC, we're mr95cents. Check them out. We got a lot of great deals on there. All right. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Don't forget, collect what you like, because if it goes up or down, you still like it. And try not to buy a box for more than $120, because what we're getting out of this stuff ain't been worth it lately. All right. Have a good one, everybody. Take care. We'll see you.